Senate Bill 5039 is a bill that was introduced last session, and it would essentially require all gubernatorial orders after 30 days to be approved by the legislature. Look, this is a bill that restores balance back to our co-equal branches of government and would finally end the one-person rule that has been in existence by the governor for nearly 700 days now. We understand that bill's not going to be heard. We understand that the majority Democrats may be coming up with their own, but we've not seen what that looks like. There are bills active in the House. Look, we need you to be engaged and continue to be engaged. We need you to hold those who are refusing to bring these bills up for a vote. We need them held responsible. This is not responsible governing to have one person in control for that length of time. I would urge you to be involved. We're going to continue to do everything we can as well. I've got several, and the first one I want to highlight is actually Senate Bill 5601. We have heard from so many school boards, superintendents, school districts, parents, the frustration of local schools not being able to enact policies or implement policies, I should say, in ways that really make sense for their communities. We have 295 school districts that represent diverse communities all across the state of Washington. It's time that we restore that flexibility. It's time that we tell the Office of Superintendent of Public Instruction that he is there to support schools, not bring down the hammer onto schools for not, quote unquote, implementing policies in the way that he sees fit. It's time to give that local control back. I'm excited about the bill. It doesn't stop bills from being passed and signed into law, but it definitely gives the school districts, school boards, communities the voice that they need to implement policies in ways that make sense. So Senate Bill 5640 is a bill I've been working on with actually the motion picture industry in Eastern Washington, which I'm excited about. We want to encourage expansion of the arts. We want to encourage opportunities for our youth to be engaged in the motion picture industry. There's so many different ways they can do that. And to have that in Eastern Washington and in our rural communities is just a huge opportunity. The bill's going to be heard next week. I'm excited about that. So stay tuned on how that develops. The third and final bill that I wanted to highlight is 5678. It would allow a utility to seek kind of guidance, if you will, that's the word I'm going to use, on projects that they propose for future energy development. You know, the legislature has passed an incredible number of laws that are really going to change how utilities do that. I'm sponsoring this bill because I want to make sure in the end that ratepayers are protected and that utilities aren't spending money they needlessly shouldn't if their projects don't go the right direction or not. So I see this bill as a guide for them to use if they want, but ultimately it's a ratepayer protection bill.